Hi everybody! Today we will talk about the perceptron, which is how we call a single unit of logic inside an artificial neural network. The perceptron is an algorithm, a set of instructions, that determines if something is true or false. One or zero, chicken or goat. It is a very basic unit. It only consists of one node, and we can imagine it as a small neuron living inside a much bigger brain. But because it's so hard to imagine such abstract concepts, let's have a quick look at an example and we go from there. So whenever we think about logic and the process of thought, we very often begin with data. So we either see something, we hear it, we smell it, we taste it, and our thought is a direct result of the data we've been exposed to. For example, I tasted a snail in Paris. My taste buds received the snail input, then they sent a signal to my brain where I came to the conclusion that I don't like snail. In the table next to me, however, there was a gentleman that also ate snail. He received the exact same input, but came to a completely different conclusion than mine. He loves snail. So even though we were both exposed to the exact same input, our process of thought led us to completely different conclusions. So just like in real life, even if we expose two different perceptrons to the exact same input data, it doesn't necessarily mean that they'll come to the same conclusion, which also known as output. In fact, we can control the thinking patterns of perceptrons with different weights and threshold. Let me show you what I mean. So, as I just mentioned, one of the main components of perceptrons is input data. For this example, we will use a set of floating point numbers, which we will call X. Each perceptron also has a set of weights. These weights determine exactly how much impact a particular input value has on the data as a whole. For example, X2 is much more significant than X1 because X2 has a weight of 0.6, which is bigger than 0.3, and therefore X2 will be much more important to our data. Now, in order to reach a logical conclusion, we will need to apply the weights on the inputs. We can do this by multiplying each of the inputs by its corresponding weight and then adding the results to get a weighted sum. Then we will need to evaluate if this sum has reached a certain threshold, also known as bias. Now, very often you will see the bias being added during the sum operation. However, in this example, just to keep things simple, we will refer it as a threshold instead. To evaluate whether the threshold was reached, we will use something called an activation function. And while there are many different activation functions out there, we will use the most simple one, which is called the step function. So with this type of function, if our threshold is 0.5, for example, and our sum is bigger than 0.5, then the function will return true or 1. On the other hand, if the weighted sum is smaller than 0.5 or equal to 0.5, then the function will return false or 0. And the key note here is that we get to choose the threshold, so it doesn't necessarily have to be 0.5. And another very important thing we get to choose is the initial set of weights. So it doesn't have to be the numbers that I selected. It could be a set of zeros, it could be a set of halves or quarters. It is all up to you, the developer. In fact, just by selecting different values for our initial set of weights, our perceptron may come to a completely different output, just like the snail-loving gentleman in Paris. And therefore, the accuracy of our neural network depends on how well we can adjust the weights to better understand our input data. And so far, we've only talked about setting initial weight values, but how exactly do we update them? I will actually answer this question in the next tutorial. But in the meanwhile, let's quickly implement everything that we've learned in Python. We will begin with our set of inputs. We will call it x input, and this will equal a list where the first item is 0.1, the second item is 0.5, and the third item is 0.2. Then we will select our initial set of weights. We will call it wweights, and this will equal a list where the first value is 0.4, the second value is 0.3, and the last value is 0.6. And the last variable we'll define will be the threshold. If you guys remember, that equals 0.5, at least in our example. And before we combine these variables inside our perceptron, let's define our activation function first. For this, we will type def step function, which will take in a single parameter that equals to our weighted sum. And if you guys remember, if our weighted sum is bigger than our threshold, then our function will return 1. Otherwise, it will return 0. And now we can move on with the actual perceptron. So let's define a brand new function called perceptron, which doesn't take any parameters. And as the first line in our function, we would like to set the weighted sum to 0. Next, we will iterate over both of these lists, multiplying the input values by its corresponding weight. We can do this with the help of a for loop. So we will type for x w in zip x input and w weight. And for each iteration, we would like to multiply x by w. And not only this, we would also like to increment our weighted sum by the results. So we will just copy this variable from above, we will paste it, and we will add a plus equals operator to increment our sum each and every time we go through the for loop. And we can of course print this sum as we go just to see our progress. And last but not least, we will leave the for loop and we will return the step function result on our weighted sum. And if we're already here, let's fix my typo. This is how you spell W weights, not how I spelled it before. And in the very, very end, we can safely set our output to equal our perceptron function. And we can print it right away. So I'll type output and I will concatenate the string instance of our output. And if everything looks good, let's give it a run. And here we can see how each iteration is increasing our weighted sum. And then in the very end, we get to 0.31, which is unfortunately smaller than our threshold of 0.5. And that's why the output of our perceptron will be 0 or false. And if you guys didn't feel like coding along with me, but you still want to have a reference to the script, you can click on the link in the description and access it through Wayscript. Thank you so much for watching, folks. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like, a comment, maybe subscribe to my channel, or even better, share this video with your coworkers or your friends. I really appreciate any form of help. Thanks again, and I'll see you very soon.